the Rise and Fall of a Dictator. Ferdinand Marcos defines the term evil genius. Ferdinand Edralin Marcos was born on September 11, 1917 in Sarat, a village in the Ilocos Norte in the Philippines. His parents were both teachers from important families. His father became a congressman, thus giving young Ferdinand an early vision of politics. His parents encouraged Ferdinand to push through his limits, not only in his studies at school, but also at activities such as wrestling, boxing, hunting, survival skills, and marksmanship, thus explaining when he was in college, his main interest was a gun, specifically a .22 caliber pistol. Julio Nalundasan was celebrating his victory over Mariano Marcos at his home. While having fun, blood spilled, skull shatters. He was shot dead. Guess what killed Nalundasan? A .22 caliber pistol. McCoy's favorite and mastered gun. The 18-year-old Ferdinand was convicted for the murder of Julio Nalundasan. While he was inside his cell, Ferdinand Marcos studied hard as a law student. He was the one who defended himself in the court trial. Nonetheless, even though he was suffering in the jail, he top-notched the bar exams with a score of 92%. He was freed because of the Chief Justice, Laurel at the time, believed that it would be a waste for our country to let a talented and smart brain rot inside the jail. Imelda Romualdez was born on July 2, 1929 in San Juan de Dios Hospital at Manila. Her parents were Vicente Romualdez and Remedios Trinidad. Her ancestors were the Lopezes of Leyte, known as one of the most powerful and influential family in the province. At the age of 18, she had been a beauty queen, thus hailed as the Rose of Tacloban because of her beauty. She then met Ferdinand Marcos, congressman of Ilocos Norte at the time, and married him. Sabi nga ni Marcos, taga sur si Imelda, taga norte ako. Together, we will rule the world. He said that jokingly, but made true by proclaiming martial law. In 1949, campaigning on promises to get the veterans' benefits, he ran for a seat in the House of Representatives. He then won 70% of the votes. After that, he was re-elected twice and became a senator at 1959. He rose through positions and finally he became the vice president of President Diosdado Macapagal. President Macapagal promised Marcos to step down after his term and make way for Ferdinand to become the next president. But Marcos was fooled. President Diosdado ran for another term, and thus Ferdinand Marcos ran for president and joined the Nationalist Party, rivaling his former boss. Surprisingly, Marcos won easily and was proclaimed as the 10th President of the Republic of the Philippines. He was the president who turned the tables around, making a dollar worth 5 Philippine peso. He signed contracts and made agreements with other countries to ensure the Philippines a spot on the trade with the whole world. He made sure that our price and other crops are up to date to make sure that we, the Philippines, is going to be a self-sufficient in food. There was a time that researchers in Thailand and Vietnam visit the Philippines to study our agricultural ways of planting. But now, we are the ones importing rice from them. He made sure that Philippines is ahead of the technology. Did you know that there was a time in Marcos' reign when researchers from Japan, study here in the Philippines because we were one of the most advanced countries in Asia? Ferdinand saw that there is a big possibility that coconut someday will become one of the most important exporting factors of our country, thus he established PCA, or Philippine Coconut Authority. I guess he was right, since now, at present, our country survives because of our coconut exports. His regime introduced a golden age to our country. But the shine of this golden age dimmed slowly, bringing our country to its dark age. The martial law. Ferdinand Marcos was the very first president who got a second term in the office. Many says that it was the dirtiest and highly paid election ever, and Marcos manipulated the votes. Many students and activists are on the streets shouting because they all want U.S. base in our country to be removed. A new group of people were making a civil unrest in Mindanao, preaching Marcos's failures and dirty plans. Then, Ferdinand Marcos planned to leave his position in 1972. Ferdinand Marcos preparing martial law may be compared to Marcos cooking a bread. To make a tasty bread, you must know how much force you apply to straighten the dough. Second, you must control the fire. Too much fire will destroy the bread or burn your hands up. Just like martial law. Marcos made moves to cloak his dictatorship behind legal and rhetoric laws. Political unrest was the reason for martial law. He suppressed the opposition. He arrested leaders. Thus, when cooking a bread, he was controlling the fire. Remember, too much fire will burn you up. Then, he dissolved the Congress. Like cooking a bread, he knew how much force you must exert to straighten the dough. Without the Congress, he will reign supreme. This part of our history is the dark age of our countries, the martial law. There were many threats among the citizens. Threats that would endanger the position of Marcoses in Malacanang. Because of this, on September 21, 1972, President Ferdinand Marcos declared martial law. He suspended the writ of habeas corpus and imposed curfew and jailed all those who opposed him, including Ninoy Aquino. On the previous year, Marcos strengthened the armed forces so that on the time he declared martial law, he could easily grasp the neck of the whole country. He ruled the archipelago with an iron fist. He proved that the government was serious on the situation by executing Lim Seng, a Chinese government who is a suspect for selling illegal drugs in the Philippines through a firing squad. Many died in these years. I can't really say that Marcoses drowned in their own pride and glory, but one thing was sure. This was the cause for the end of their reign.
So, maraming salamat po sa mga nanood. Para sa mga hindi naman nanood, nakahongin ninyo. Okay, yun lang po. Salamat nga po pala sa nanay at tatay ko at pinag-aral po nila ako dito sa Ateneo na may Mac, napakagandang Mac, at may napakapoging teacher, si Sir Yuri Bongalos. So yun lang po ulit. Ito nga po pala ako, class number 24, Modulara, final project. Okay, yeah, boy, rock and roll. Rock and roll.